Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Today we're going to do a cocktail out of this little cocktail book produced by Rhum Barbancourt. And this would have been given as a souvenir at the distillery in Haiti, sometime between 1928 and the beginning of World War II. It's undated, but based on some of the things that are in here, you can kind of get that date range. Now, Rhum Barbancourt, you're going to notice, is spelt with an H. That means that it is a French-style rum, which is different than an English-style rum or a Spanish-style rum. And the French style of rums is made from freshly squeezed cane juice. So they squeeze the sugar cane. That resulting liquid is then fermented into rum. It's often called rum agricole in French. Versus English and Spanish-style rums that don't have the H, and those are produced from molasses. And Spanish-style rums are actually spelt R-O-N. Although R-U-M is the English translation. And depending on which island you're on, that use of molasses could be anywhere from a really light molasses to a really dark molasses, which gives a different style and body and taste and so on and so forth. Throw in the Portuguese, and they make a rum in Brazil, which is the French-style rum agricole, except they call it cachaça, which does not lead to any confusion whatsoever. So, there is other confusion, and I'll get to that at the end with the H here in Canada. Now, I'm going to do this two ways. I'm going to use the Barbancourt rum agricole, but I'm also going to use an English-style rum, Angostura, and we'll see if that translates into a difference in the taste of the cocktail. So each cocktail starts with some granulated sugar, two dashes of Angostura bitters, which get everywhere. And this one is going to get the rum Barbancourt. And do I have enough? Do I have enough? Just. And this one is going to get the Angostura. Now I'm going to ice and shake these one at a time. And as you learned from the stirring video, this part is edited. And we'll get rid of that ice. And double strain. And they get a lemon peel as a garnish. So, doesn't say to spritz the lemon over top.
Hey, friends.
Or run it around the edge, but you know, makes for a better cocktail. Makes for a better cocktail, I think.
I appreciate you making it special just for me. Thank you.
So, made with a French style rum, a French agricole, and made with an English style rum, which, now here's the weird thing. I said rum, French style rum is spelled with an H, and English style rum is spelled with an R-U-M.
Yes.
Except in Canada, where we have a language law that says every label has to be translated both English and French. And so they translate the French version, rum with an H, but then on the English side of the label, it's rum without the H. And when you get an English rum, it's the exact opposite. So you need to know where the rum came from in order to decipher the label. It tells you a little bit about the style of what's in the bottle and where it came from. Anyway, that's my own little thing. So you could get confused if you were reading the label and you say, but it's spelled both ways, Glen. What do you know? What do you know about anything? Which is probably a fair point.
That's a pretty decent...
Okay.
Pretty decent drink.
So that's you've got the French rum. You've got the actual rum Barbancourt. Okay. And that one is the Angostura rum.
Okay. Oh, no.
Completely different, isn't
it? No, that's not right at all. What is this
drink? That one's delightful.
Yes.
That one is delightful.
No, not at all. What is this drink called?
This is just Cocktail Rum Barbancourt.
Okay, I like the simplicity of the name. It's a very simple drink, and it is a very clean flavor.
Very nice.
No.
Not so nice. Which is, you know, here's the thing. A lot of people get down on my choices of what I bring out for rums.
Mm-hmm.
And vodkas. And all of that thing. And so you really have to find one that you like and find one that works in a cocktail.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously, coming from the distillery, they've...
taking the time.
Taking the time to build something.
Made for their flavor.
Made for their flavor. So, and this is the 5 étoiles.
The fifth star.
5 stars.
$1.50 or $15 a case.
You get this for $15 a case in the 1920s from the distillery. Okay, so.
We'll have to fight over that.
We're going
to
fight over that one. Explore rums. Explore the different styles of rums different rums from different islands and different styles. It's endless. Absolutely endless. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.